I've always had a special affinity towards the Staticor. I mean, what's not to like? It's got cool animations, it makes things go boom, and the effects are super cool as well. And today, my friends, we're gonna be diving deeper into this Mastery Rank 10 secondary weapon. As always, my name is Lazar, and I got a couple of builds lined up. Something cheap, something affordable that most Tenors should be able to build, but of course, we also got the quote-unquote endgame setup with Prime mods and a Riven. That said though, please keep in mind that my builds and guides usually take a new player friendly approach. I like to take my time and explain whatever I feel is necessary for newer players. So in case you're a vet and you already know most of this stuff, please, bear with me. And with that out of the way, let's jump into the Staticor. Let's begin by checking out how the weapon handles without any mods equipped. And for that, just a couple of free shots. The Staticor is classified as being dual pistols, but it acts the most like a thrown weapon, and as any thrown weapon, you should have an overhand throw and an underhand throw. Unfortunately, right now, the Staticor only has a overhand throw. I'm not really sure what that's all about. It may be a bug. I tested several Warframes, several stances, and several missions, and I even restarted the game several times, but it still kinda does this. Which looks a little bit on the weird side. Now, don't get me wrong, it will not have an effect on the weapon's performance because the underhand throw used to land in the exact same spot as the overhand throw and the fire rate is not affected, so bear that one in mind. Now, let's talk about the projectiles that the Staticor fires. These are plasma balls of sorts. You have two options, quick fire, 2.4 meter explosion upon contact, or you can fully charge using 4 ammo. I know that the wiki specifies 5, but it's actually 4. And then you're gonna be getting a much larger explosion. 4 times the damage, because, well, it consumes 4 ammo. And of course, you're gonna be getting 9.6 meters worth of radius on your explosion. Other than that, what you can also do is keep your charge in, like so, walk around, and in case you come in contact with an enemy, you're gonna get this AoE knockdown effect on your enemy. So if you need a little bit of crowd control, you can just do that. It's a guaranteed knockdown, right? So if you're surrounded or something, you can also do that. Keep in mind that charging your shot will keep on consuming ammo. Even though you are not getting extra damage, you will be getting 4 times the amount of damage as soon as you reach 4 charge. Let me show you, and 4. 18 ammo left, and 4. That's it. Now let's have a closer look at stats, and keep in mind there are certainly some inconsistencies when it comes to the Staticor right now, but I will do my best to clarify all of them. First of all, mod capacity is 60 out of 60, and if your Staticor comes with only 30 out of 30 jump into actions, plug in that Auto King Catalyst, double that mod capacity. You can pay 20 plat to have one installed, you can grind one from Nightwave, you can get a blueprint from the daily sortie, or you can get them as a reward from some events in Warframe. From my humble point of view, it's still worth fully modding the Staticor. Accuracy on this one is going to be 16.7. You can definitely go with Magnum Force. Let me show you the effect. We're going to put on some multi-shot like so. We're going to spawn in some targets or a target. Yes, definitely a target. Yes, it's true. The projectiles will kind of have this weird travel path sometime, especially the multi-shot projectiles. Let me show you exactly what I mean. But you're aiming to get damage with the explosion. And considering the range of the explosion on the charge shot, 9.6 is not really going to matter. And this is going to be for quick shot. It's fine. Come on, it's fine. You can definitely go with Magnum Force if you so desire. When I first reviewed this weapon back in 2018, Magnum Force was not an option because it was back when it was 66% extra damage with the minus accuracy. So basically worthless back then. Charge rate on this one is gonna be 1 second. Okay, critical chance is a bit low at 14%, but the critical multiplier is nice at 2.2x. This is what I like to call barely worth critical stats. Barely worth modding for crit. Keep in mind that when it comes to secondary weapons, we got prime mods, prime pistol gambit, prime target cracker, so prime critical mods. The weapon plexilus or exilus slot. Now this one is definitely worth unlocking and using this thing right here, lethal momentum with 40% projectile flight speed. Now if you remember the old Staticor, the charge shot used to be so slow. I mean, you could outrun it, easily outrun it. But as you can see, that is no longer the case. And if you add lethal momentum into the mix, it's really a much better experience than it was before. Let's see what else. Magazine of 48, a fire rate of 3.5, which is good, multi-shot of 1. Noise alarming, reload of 1.5 seconds, super quick reload, which matters a lot for usability. But unfortunately, I'm not the only player that knows that a Staticor is an awesome secondary weapon, so Riven Disposition, only 1 out of 5, which means Rivens are not really worth it. Unless you get a god roll of a god roll of a godlike roll or something like that. If you get a normal roll, basically, essentially, it's pretty hard to get a Riven which is slottable on the weapon or worth putting in. Status chance, solid 28%. The damage is gonna be radiation by default, my friends, which is fantastic. You can make corrosive radiation. You can even make corrosive radiation and heat, or you can make viral. I don't really recommend viral on secondary weapons right now, considering that if the secondary weapon cannot get a consistent amount of slash on your target, and especially if you're going down to Deimos, because enemies on Deimos, most of them are immune to viral damage. Now, what I want to draw your attention to is the damage listed on this stat screen, which is, I feel, is not entirely correct. Have a look. If you are to go by these stats, the charge attack deals almost as much damage as the normal quickshot attack. Definitely not four times the amount of damage that we were promised, that the wiki mentions. On the other hand, the wiki also mentions that the charge attack takes 5 ammo and it takes 4, so there you go. Now, I did test this because, again, this seemed weird, a little bit inconclusive, if you will. And I will show you on a singular corrupted heavy goon. First, we'll do a normal attack. I want you to take a look at the white damage. You got... white damage, please. 8 plus 4, 8 plus 4, 8 plus 4. Sometimes you also get 8 plus 4 plus 9, okay? So 12 to 13 normal damage straight to a headshot, right? If you go charge attack, 33.14. You don't know what, there's two numbers, it's simple. One is the projectile making contact with a target, and the second one is the explosion. So that is going to be 14 plus 33 white damage. Don't take a look at the crits, take a look at the consistent white damage, right? Fully charge and fire. 14.33, fully and fire. 14.33. You get that? One more time. Fully charged, 14.33. Again, it seemed kind of kooky considering the damage numbers, but again, I think the Staticor is a little bit bugged, but not from a functionality perspective right now. I think it's just a visual bug, essentially. What else is there to talk about? Nothing. Let's have a look at a standard build, shall we? And you get damage at Hornet Strike, multi-shot with Barrel Diffusion, Lethal Torrent, Critical Chance, Critical Damage combo between Pistol Gambit, Target Cracker, and you also got 260-60 mods forming Corrosive. As I stated before, on secondary weapons, I would still stick to Corrosive, especially if you're going down to Deimos. The problem with me recommending something like this is the fact that Jolt can only be obtained from Battle Key tier the Void Trader. No, it cannot be farmed from the game for some reason. You're gonna have to ask the developer on that one. But if you see Battle bring the 60-60 electricity mods, make sure you have a copy of each. And in case you don't have a whole lot of Ducats or a whole lot of credits just yet, you're small in MR, only Jolt and Voltaic Strike are 100% a must-have from Battle. The other two you can farm from the game. It's a pain, but it is farmable. So bear that one in mind. Of course, little momentum. And the last slot, this is what I like to call your option slot. Here's one option that we can go for, but again, the damage. See, definitely does not reflect the four times amount of damage. It should reflect the quick shot damage plus radial attack with the charge damage plus the charge radial attack. Also, I want to draw your attention to the falloff on the charge radial attack, 90%. Sure, the range is huge at 9.6, but honestly, 90%, that's just horrible. Essentially, you're only gonna get that big bada boom damage towards the center, and it's gonna drop off really, really powerful, really, really quick. So bear that one in mind. Now, what was I saying? Oh yes, you can go Magnum Force if you want to. Magnum Force is definitely not a horrible idea, so this is gonna be option number one. Then we're gonna try a little bit of heat, and then we're gonna try a little bit of fire rate. My favorite option on this weapon still remains fire rate. Uh-oh. Not just one darted. More corrupted heavy goons, because one is never enough. And besides, when they show up in your missions, did you notice? They never show up just one of them. There's always like a pack of the bloody things, depending on what kind of content you guys like to play. You guys like Steel Path? I don't like Steel Path, but you guys like Steel Path, right? Anyway, charge attack. Boom! Now, normally, you're gonna go for to shoot for the feet, right? But again, take a look at that falloff. Take a look at how much damage I'm doing towards the center and how much damage I'm doing towards the edge. That's a pretty big drop off. And as before, since I have critical mods on the weapon, if you can go for a headshot, just go for a headshot. And this would be rapid fire. Rapid fire body shots. So you can get an idea of what kind of damage you can expect. And I'm also going to be shooting for the feet. Some of you guys said, hey, Lazar, why don't you shoot for the feet or body shots? Here you go. That's for the feet. Let's do one more with body shots and do a little bit more charge. As you can see, there is a pretty big difference between going for a headshot and not going for a headshot. See that? A whole lot more damage than before because of the extra headshot multiplier. And that's pretty much it for performance with normal standard everyday mods. Magnum Force is definitely not a bad idea on this weapon, but you can replace it with a little bit of heat. Let's go with heat. Oh, and let me know if you like this testing procedure more than the old testing procedure. When we shoot for the feet, then we shoot for the body, then we shoot for head. Essentially, we... Wait, that's the wrong elemental combo. Ha, you thought you got me, but you didn't. See? It's fixed now. Well, actually, it would be better like this. There we go. Now it's fixed. So, what do you got on the weapon? You got heat, corrosive, and radiation, which should spell doom for any grenier. Once again, level 120, corrupted heavy goons, and we're gonna make a quick test with heat as well. First off, a couple of charge shots, like so, one, a two, and a three. You're gonna love fire rate when we get to fire rate, because you're gonna be able to do charge shots a whole lot more faster. So this is the kind of damage you can expect. Of course, the targets in the center took a whole lot more than the targets from the edge. Let's go for a couple of quick shots on the head. Beautiful, absolutely beautiful, and a couple of body shots as well. Of course, having the heat on the weapon right now does a number on the corrupted heavy goons, because you got corrosive and heat, that armor is basically getting annihilated. And this is the kind of performance you can expect. And finally, feet shot. Shooting for the feet and all that. There you go. Hey, I'm not judging. I'm not fantastic at aiming either. So if you want to use the weapon like so, you can definitely do so, but it's not the most effective way. Finally, my favorite mod, fire rate mods. Always fire rate is fantastic. Now, it may be true it's not the most intelligent thing in the world, you might run out of ammo and all whatnot, but who cares, because you can use a pistol ammo mutation, you can use carrier with the ammo case, or you can simply drop a pad. So fire rate, I know a lot of you guys like to go with this one, anemic agility, and I can understand why. 90% fire rate at the cost of 15% damage. But my friends, Gunslinger gives you 72%, so the difference is 18 only, and doesn't take away any of your damage. This is not the same comparison as for primary weapons with vile acceleration versus speed trigger. In this case, I'd rather go with gun in the slinger. One more time, corrupted heavy goons level 120. And this is how I play with the weapon from mission to mission. I simply jump and then do this. And when where they land, they kind of land. I don't really aim for a headshot or a body shot or whatever. I just and hope that everything dies. Sometimes everything dies and sometimes I die. It happens. It's Warframe, depending on the level of the content, of course. Once again, the most effective way is gonna be to go for a headshot. And now you can fire those charge shots a whole lot more faster than before. Now you should have a pretty good idea of what kind of performance you can expect out of the Staticor with normal, average, everyday mods. Now, there's one more thing which I do want to show you before we talk about Riven mods, and of course that's going to be Prime mods, because a whole lot more players have Prime mods than they have Riven mods. And again, getting a Riven for this one, which is actually worth using, is going to be a tad difficult. Prime mods! We're going to get rid of that, we're going to go to Prime Target Cracker and Prime Pistol Gamba, like so. We no longer have room for the stupid projectile flight speed mod. God, I'm not farming another time. I'm not doing it. One more time, level 120 corrupted heavy wounds, and we're gonna be going with the fire rate mod. Again, this is the one that I enjoy the most. It's not necessarily the smartest idea, but it's the one I like the most. And it's the one I recommend. If you manage to get that headshot, beautiful, absolutely fantastic. Let's try a couple of charge shots. Boom, boom, and of course the ideal way, something like so. Big explosion, but again, keep in mind that falloff is really, really nasty on the charge shot. 90% is absolutely bloody huge. Let's try a couple of body shots. Body shot, body shot, body shot, body shot, but damn, this annoys me. And a couple of shooting for the feet, yeah. And that's pretty much it, performance with Prime mods. Now let's talk about Riven. This position is only 1 out of 5, my friend, so to get an actual good one, you either gotta be super lucky or super rich, one of the two. I'm neither. Yes, right? No. But this one is a loaner from a friend, from my buddy, multi-shot damage and plus weapon recoil. This is worth. This is hashtag worth, definitely, considering everything. The problem, I no longer have an option slot, so no more fire rate, no more extra damage from Magnum Force, no more anything. So take a look at the value of this pole one right now, okay? But this is a double positive with a negative, okay? 174% damage rounded up, 165. So you see, you still get more than Magnum Force plus the multi-shot, right? Which is 84.4. It's not as much as Barrel Diffusion. So right now, this one is worth like 1.7 mods with the current disposition, something along those lines. And let's test out the weapon like Sue. I have my own Staticor Riven, but it's not as good as this one. Of course it's not. It never is. It never bloody is. And as per the usual, I'm just gonna bombard the crap out of these targets. And of course, with the multi-shot means more explosions. Look at that. Look at that. Chomp, 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 chomp. Beautiful! Absolutely bloody beautiful. A couple of big explosions, because why the hell not? We're gonna go shoot for the feet. Essentially try to maximize that explosion damage, so I'm trying to put the explosion in between my primary targets, like so. And that's performance with Prime mods and a pretty good Riven. What can I say, my friends? Let's be honest here. For an AoE weapon, it's decent, but it's nothing fantastic. If we had Riven Disposition of 5 out of 5, that would be fantastic. So stop playing with it. Stop playing with it so we can get that Riven Disposition higher and higher. But if you really want to blow stuff up, you can either go with Lady Mirage Prime or you can go with Harrow. Both are a good idea because, well, the Staticor doesn't really have a whole lot of crit, so you can go with Lord Harrow. Check the animation like this. Isn't that freaking amazing? I love that stance. I should make a wallpaper like that, definitely. Corrosive Projection is meta when it comes to, well, heavily armored targets. Arcane Avenger is a fantastic idea. This is the most powerful offensive arcane in Warframe. Farm from the third Eidolon down on Cetus. 45% critical chance bonus for 12 seconds. This is a bonus additive after, so it stacks on top of what you already have. It doesn't care about the base critical chance of your weapon, applying to your primary, secondary, and to your melee as well. Arcane Rage is not gonna help us, but Arcane Precision will. It's a secondary arcane, also from the third Eidolon down on Cetus on headshot, 100% chance for 300% damage to pistols for 18 seconds. Now, if you're gonna be using Harrow, right, oh, let's fix the fashion, gotta fix it, I'm sorry, it's bothering me. There we go, that's the right shaded red, good. If you're gonna use Harrow, not a whole lot of point using Prime Pistol Gambit, right? You can keep the critical damage, definitely keep the critical damage, but instead what we can go for in this specific scenario is our option slot. So we can go for Magnum Force for more damage, but my favorite, yes, my favorite. You wanna see Anemic? Fine, we'll go with Anemic Agility, just for you guys. I'm a sucker for you guys. After all, you do watch my videos, so there's that. We're gonna be unpausing the AI, so well, also bump up the level. Yes, 150, so it's a bit more fair considering we are using Warframe buffs. We're gonna be unpausing the AI so they can hit me and I can get me buffs, my friends. Me buffs. We're gonna activate Harrow's 4th ability. Save everybody in the party. Get zero thanks for it. Yes, I know. Fantastic frame, fantastic supporty, offensive, jack of all many trades. Harrow, build this frame is great. I know the farm is hard, but still, worth it. And his second ability, which will grant me fire rate as well as reload speed, which is needed on the weapon. I got everything I need, but the problem is I gotta go for a headshot. If I don't get the headshot, I'm not gonna get the full benefit from Harrow's fourth ability. Of course, if I get the headshot, it's gonna be a one shot. But if I don't get the headshot, it's not really gonna be, look, body shot. See that? And of course, rapid fire. That's the, what you saw there happening between those two Grenier is the radiation proc. They kind of start firing at each other, as they should at the end of the day. So you see, I know I showcased Harrow because you guys fought, oh my god, crit Harrow, right? But in this case, because you gotta get a headshot, otherwise you're not getting the full crit benefit, you're only getting 50% bonus additive after from Harrow's 4, I rather use it with Lady Mirage Prime. So let's do exactly that. Now Lady Mirage just offers damage, she's not biased. She just offers damage. Glorious amounts of damage. Take a look at that stance. Beautiful, beautiful stance, is it not? I love the stances. There we go. Ah, the red is a little bit too... I'll fix that later. Later, much later. Corrosive Projection as before, and we're going to be using Arcane Avenger with Arcane Precision, just like we used for Harrow. These, of course, are optional and entirely up to you. Sentinel will help me. Okay, a Sentinel will not help me in this case simply because it is a secondary weapon. So the bonuses from the Vigilante set do not apply. One more time, Corrupted Heavy Goons, level 150. Yes, I do love the weapon. I think that's pretty much good. We're gonna activate Mirage's free ability for a fantastic damage increase as well as her ever so lovely colognes. There we go. There we go. You see that? You see that? No crit, but still. Charge shot. Kaboof! Where'd he go? Hey! Where'd you go? Mama? They're gone. I'm all alone. Again. Well, you know what I do to get friends in the simulacrum. I just spawn some more. This is why I love the simulacrum. I get to spawn my own friends and get to play with them. Nobody wants to play with Papa. Oh, there they go! There they go. There's one and there's the other one. I just love that. Can I do it one more time? One more time. Just one more time. I promise. I'll just do it one more time. It's fantastic to go for a combination such as this. Now, of course, I am a little bit biased. No, I'm a lot biased because I love the weapon and I love Mirage. So, I mean, what's not to love, my friends? What is not to love from this? As always, my name has been Lazar. Thank you guys so much for watching. Like, share, and subscribe if you enjoy the content. And if you got any sorts of feedback for me, by all means, drop it in the comment section down below. Yes, the Staticor is a nice weapon. It's not really as powerful as it used to be from my humble point of view. It's a fun weapon. It's worth using. It's extremely easy. No matter if you want to go for body shot, head shot, whatever shot, the Staticor will prevail in the end. And I do recommend this outstanding secondary weapon. You can also catch me on Twitch, Facebook, Twitter, all the usual places. And if you love the content, hey, consider supporting us via Patreon. Until next time, my friends. Bye-bye.